The Philippine Armed Forces raising the need for more naval assets amid increasing tensions in the West Philippine Sea. The AFP's call follows yet another incident of harassment and dangerous maneuvers by the Chinese Coast Guard during last week's resupply mission to the BRP Sierra Madre at the Ayuin Shoal. The military says there is a need for more maritime assets like submarines to beef up the country's defense.
We have to increase our capability to conduct maritime domain awareness. What, we have to see what's happening in our environment and other capabilities that will make sure that we have a 360 degrees capability to know what is happening. Having a submarine is advantageous to any country. But wag naman sana ninyong isipin na warmongering tayo, ha? We are just developing our capability because we just want to protect what is ours, what will benefit the Filipino people.
As for the National Security Council, it believes the Philippines also needs to strengthen its alliance with other powerful countries. The last week, Manila, Tokyo, and Washington agreed to boost cooperations to ensure peace and safety in the South China Sea.
Very critical that we have good relationships with them and show to China that we have this network of alliances that support our position in the West Philippine Sea.
The U.S. seeking stronger ties with Vietnam has nothing to do with China. That declaration coming from U.S. President Joe Biden during his historic trip to Hanoi. Biden visited Hanoi as Vietnam elevates the U.S. to its highest diplomatic status, a comprehensive strategic partner. Now, the move shows just how far ties between the two countries have evolved since the Vietnam War.
And one of the things that is going on now is China is beginning to change some of the rules of the game in terms of trade and other issues. And so one of the things we talked about, for example, is that they're now talking about making sure that no one in the Chinese government can use a Western cell phone, those kinds of things. And so really what this trip was about, it was less about containing China. I don't want to contain China. I just want to make sure we have a relationship with China that is on the up and up, squared away. It's not about containing China. It's about having a stable base in the Indo-Pacific.
Meanwhile, U.S. President Joe Biden revealed he spoke with Chinese Premier Li Qiang during the G20 summit in India. He adds he still wants to meet the Chinese President Xi Jinping after a 10-month gap in communication.
So it's not like there's a crisis if I don't personally speak to him. It'd be better if I did. But I think, look, this is not a criticism. It's an observation. He has his hands full right now. He has overwhelming unemployment with his youth. One of the major economic tenets of his plan isn't working at all right now. I'm not happy for that, but it's not working. So he's trying to figure out.
The death toll from the powerful quake that struck Morocco last week climbs to over 2,100. But the extent of damage and casualties remain unclear as researchers race to reach more remote areas hit by the deadly tremor.
A security camera captures the moment a 6.8 magnitude earthquake struck Morocco as a man runs for his life through rubble. It was a common scene last Friday as the quake shook parts of this North African nation. Morocco's public broadcaster, SNRT, released images of cars crushed by rubble, highlighting the challenges facing rescue workers. Much of the quake's damage was in mountainous regions where villagers had already begun burying their dead as of Saturday. And as Moroccans and tourists visiting their country took part in blood drives at area clinics, Morocco's King Mohammed VI ordered the nation's armed forces to mobilize search and rescue teams. He also called for special prayer services Sunday at mosques. Many Moroccans have been sleeping in the streets for fear of aftershocks destroying their already damaged homes. The United States and others have offered support to the government and people of Morocco.
We've reached out immediately to the Moroccan government, made very clear to them that we are prepared to assist in any way that we can. We have the U.S. Agency for International Development, which takes the lead in our efforts, mobilizing, and we're waiting to hear from the Moroccan government how we can be of most assistance. But we're tracking this very carefully, and our hearts go out to the people of Morocco who suffered this devastating earthquake, and we stand ready to help in any way that we can.
For those living through the disaster, their government's efforts have not gone unnoticed.
Authorities are doing their best, and even like in the high Atlas Mountains where people lost their lives and where that earthquake hit harder, they're trying to help. And I'm very sure that our people, our Moroccan people and our Moroccan community can get together and we can go through this.
Morocco has not seen this powerful an earthquake since 2004, when a magnitude 6.3 quake killed more than 550 people in one of the country's poorer regions. Morocco's worst earthquake in modern times happened in 1960. It destroyed most of the popular tourist destination of Agadir and killed at least 12,000 people. Arash Arabasadi, VOA News.
More world leaders offered to send help to quake-hit Morocco. French President Emmanuel Macron says France stands ready to deploy technical teams to Morocco if and when the kingdom asks for it. A French citizen died in the tremor while 8 others were hurt. In Turkey, also on standby, say hundreds of its aid workers are ready to travel to Morocco to help quake victims. Earlier this year, Turkey and neighboring Syria were also hit by a devastating quake, killing over 50,000 people. Pope Francis, meanwhile, offers prayers for the victims of Morocco's deadly quake in more than 6 decades. He also urged crowds in St. Peter's Square to remember those who died in the tragedy.
Desidero esprimere la mia vicinanza.
I would like to express my condolences to the dear people of Morocco, hit by a devastating earthquake. I pray for the injured, for those who have lost their lives, so many of them, and for their relatives. I thank the rescuers and all those who are working to alleviate the suffering of the people. May everyone's complete support sustain the population at this tragic time. We stand with the people of Morocco.
Concreto aiuto di tutti possa sostenere la popolazione in questo tragico momento.
No Filipino casualties have been reported in the powerful earthquake that hit Morocco last Friday. That's according to the Philippine Migrant Workers Department. Embassy personnel were also reported safe. There are around 4,600 Filipinos living in Morocco.
So far, walang reported overseas citizens affected. And we continue to monitor the situation on the ground.
Nanonood lang po ako ng TV, nakaupo po ako sa sofa na parang yumuyugyug na, and then napatingala po ako sa ilaw. So parang nagsisway na po yung ilaw. So that's when I thought na hindi lang ako inaantok, talaga may lindol po.
Manila's finance chief asserts the controversial Maharlika Investment Corporation should be headed by a Filipino. Secretary Benjamin Jokno made that remark after the Treasury Bureau last week began accepting applications for senior members of the board. Now, weeks before the September 27 deadline, all positions on the board are yet to be filled. These include a president, a CEO, 2 regular directors, and 3 independent directors. Jokno earlier said the country's sovereign wealth fund would be operational before the year ends. Rice prices in the country seem to normalize in the coming weeks. The Philippine Agriculture Department says rice supply is set to stabilize soon as farmers begin to harvest crops this month.
At ang Region 3 po, ito po yung ating rice gunnery, ay nagsabi po sa amin kahapon na nagsisimula na rin po mag-deliver ng mga bigas, yung pong local na produce.
The next week or 2 weeks, mararamdaman na natin yung pagdami ng locally produced na bigas sa merkado, at inaasahan natin na magno-normalize na ang presyo ng bigas.
Meanwhile, government says distribution of cash aid to small rice retailers affected by the cap on rice price will still continue.